See, the first important point is having your accounts on social media, right? Social media is always evolving. There are new things coming up on social media. There is a new button or there's new update on social media is coming. So staying active on social media is very important. Secondly, you should have a gist for social media, right? You should like spending time with people. You should like talking to them, or you should just know what is target audience, right? To understand, you should able to understand people to start working as a social media marketing. There are definitely a lot of things you can do in digital marketing. But social media marketing, which is part of digital marketing, is something that is that you should have a you should be a people person, just to say, right? So our today's topic will be how do people consume content on Facebook and Instagram? What is organic social media marketing and what is paid social media marketing? What are the ad targeting options? So if you are running a campaign on social media, what are your options? How do you create a campaign? And what are the metrics to measure a successful Facebook campaign? And then we'll go live. We'll create a new campaign together, guys. Okay. So just a little bit of history to talk about it. How social media evolved. So like I started with Orkut. I'm sure a lot of people here must have started with the Orkut here. Or Yahoo or Gmail at our time. And then we shifted to Facebook, and then a lot of things came, Twitter, Tumblr. Now a lot of people who are gamers here must be using Discord and other platforms. TikTok recently got banned. So there are a lot of platforms, but it eventually started with having a Gmail account and having a Orkut, right? What does social media include? Social media is It's a huge place. It has 3.96 billion people, which are social media users. And in India, there are around 400 million people. So it has a pretty big audience. You can target a lot of people on social media. What are the benefits of social media? One is large user base. So as you can see, it has so many people that you can target. Almost everybody. Like if you have a product that targets basically men, you can use social media. If you have a product that target only college students, only female audience which are in college, which are studying in first year, you can do that. Or if you want people who are living in your area, you can easily target them. So it has a large user base, it has higher targeting options, easy word of mouth marketing. So people talk on social media, they share, you must have shared posts, you must have shared memes, right? So when you like a content, when you are then you share those things, right? And when we see a hoarding, right, we are seeing a hoarding basically, or we are seeing an ad in television that says, okay, this product is bad. We know that it's just advertising, but when one of our friends shares something on social media, we actually believe that because it's coming from someone we know and someone we trust. So it produces easy word of mouth and it has a credible source, right? So before going into social media, right, if you have a company, you want to start social media marketing, you should define your purpose. Like, what is your purpose of coming on social media, right? Is it just to scroll on see what your competitors are doing, or scroll and chat with other people, or do you have any specific aim for coming on social media, right? So there are a lot of marketing techniques, as a lot of people you might be knowing. In digital marketing, it consists of social media. It has search engine optimization, right? It has Google AdWords, media buying. So it has a lot of techniques. So why you should be using social media, your purpose should be defined in that way, right? So there are a few purposes that basically people come for. Generally, that is awareness. So suppose you want to create a brand awareness, you want people to know about you, right? So if you have a new brand, you are just started selling t-shirts, or you have started a new service, you want people to know about it, right? You want your post to reach people. That is called awareness. A consideration is engagement. You want them to like, or you have just made a website, right? So not, the only making a website is not important. You need people to go there, right? So for that, you need social media, right? Someone has asked, which is the best platform to create ads? So we'll come to this after this slide. So guys, engage. Another is purchase. So definitely, if you are selling something, suppose you are selling t-shirts, right? Suppose you are selling meme t-shirts, right? You are someone who is very interested in memes, and you print them on social on t-shirts, and you start selling them, right? So the obviously the main purpose of coming on social media, spending money on social media, will be to get purchases. You want people to know about you, and you want them to purchase new t-shirts. And you want people who have already purchased t-shirts from you to see other t-shirts that you have, right? So that is one goal. Delight is build online relationship with customers. That is, if you are selling something, you want to talk to them, right? You must have seen that if you are buying something, lot of the times people ask you to rate you on Google, or they ask to rate you on Facebook, or they if you have been cheated, right? If you order something on from Zomato or Swiggy, if you don't get a right food, sometimes if you post that on social media, you immediately get feedback from them, or you immediately get your money back, right? So building online relationship with customers is very important here. Advocacy is getting positive reviews of brand online. So when you encourage your users to post about you, you must have seen a lot of influencers who, or a lot of people who go to restaurants and they just make videos of foods and videos of other places, right? They share about it. So that is how you encourage users to get positive response. So your purpose of coming on social media should be definitive. Next is, how do people consume content on social? So before that, somebody asked, which is the best platform? So guys, there's no definitive answer that which is the best platform. I think you should be clear in like, you should be clear like what is your main goal, right? So if you are business in B2B business, right? So suppose you deals with businesses, or you are a manufacturer of let's say you are a manufacturer of paint, right? So you won't sell your sell your product directly to customers, right? You want businesses to connect to you. So LinkedIn would be the best, right? Or if you are a lifestyle blogger, or if you are a beauty or something influencer, right? Instagram would be the best place for you. So it all depends on your goal. So how do people consume content on social, right? As you can see, what you should be able to plan, right? How you should make your content. Is it better to make videos, social media post, news article, research content? So suppose if you are a newspaper, right? A newspaper, if it starts publishing videos, it won't get that much traction, because people, if they want videos, they will go to a news channel. They won't go to a newspaper, right? They want news articles from it, like Bloomberg. Bloomberg sometimes posts videos also, but let's say Indian Express, right? So these are newspapers. If they start posting videos, people won't go to it. They will go to some other platform, right? Or there are journals, I think some of you might have heard about Lancet journal, right? People publish their PhDs in them. So they publish research content, right? Same way videos. So if you are an adventure vlogger, or if you are a beauty vlogger, right? If you start posting blogs, very less people will see your blogs, right? But if you start posting videos, like the top 10 places we visited and such things, you will get a lot more traction there. So that is how people consume content now. That is why TikTok was a huge, TikTok was hugely popular, right? Because it was all video content. Even now, if you will see Instagram Reels, you can scroll very fast. So consume, you can divide it in two posts, right? Consume thoroughly is people who not only just check your content, but they actually watch your content, right? So videos, if it starts get your if it gets your attention in first 5 seconds, if it gets your attention, you will see a whole video. But if it doesn't get your attention, you will just skip a video, right? So and skim is when people start scrolling. Okay, so that is how videos, social media posts, news articles, research content, this that is how it is consumed, right? So coming to Facebook and Instagram marketing, that two platforms we'll be talking about today. Okay, so I think a lot of you might be knowing Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp is owned by the Facebook only, right? So today we'll be talking about Facebook and Instagram. What is the difference between organic social media marketing and paid social media marketing, right? So for example, if you have two options, right? Coming to social media, you have created a page. Now you have two options. Either you can put money in it or you don't put money in it, right? You do social organic marketing. That is, if you don't put money in it, that is organic marketing. Or you start doing paid social, right? You post something and then you promote it and you put money in it, right? So what is the difference between two and how would you choose them, right? So content the brands put on our social media pages without any promotion. So if you don't put money in it, that is organic marketing. And if you start putting money, it is paid social. It post only reaches 0.4 to 1%. So like if you are on Instagram, right? If you have 1,000 followers, you must have seen that if you post something, you will get 100 or 200 likes at max, right? Same way but in paid marketing, if you put money in it, you will get a lot more likes, right? So organic reaches a very small amount of people, right? No niche targeting available. So if you are posting on Instagram, okay, you don't have options, right? If I post something, I don't have option that it should reach only the male audience or only the female audience, right? Or it should reach to a certain age category. But in paid social media marketing, you do have those options, okay? And the last point is, you don't create campaigns or you don't create ad sets in organic, but in paid social, you can create ad sets. Like you can easily compare, like if men's are reacting more or if women are reacting or people from particular age or particular area are reacting more to your content, right? So that is how you can, that is the difference between organic and social media marketing. Now, see, what happens is nowadays, if you will see, brands do not focus a lot on organic social media, right? Because it's not that effective anymore, specifically for Facebook, okay? Nowadays, not the big brands, not like Coca-Cola or somebody, but if you will see a startup or somebody, they will only focus on paid social media and they will put a very little focus on organic. Like they will do posting and all, but that is because if somebody clicks on your ads and they come and see your page, they should see some content there, right? They should see some activity. So that is the only reason organic social media marketing is done today. Your main money, if you will say, is used for paid social media marketing only. So paid campaigns on Facebook and Instagram. Okay, a little bit of theory before we go deep into it. Suppose if you have a brand, okay, and you are a startup, and you decided that, okay, social media would be good for my marketing mix. And now you have to decide that now you have decided, okay, I'll put money in paid social media marketing also. But now you have to decide your objective, okay? What you will do now, how you will spend your money, okay? Suppose you have decided that, okay, my monthly budget would be 1 lakh rupees. So how would you spend those 1 lakh rupees? So that will be your first objective. So if you are a brand, right? If you're a brand, you want people to know about you. You want to create awareness. You want to create brand awareness, right? You want people to know that, okay, one such brand is coming up. So for example, if I have a bakery shop, right? I'm opening a bakery shop in Khargar, or somebody is in Delhi. So let's say somebody is opening a bakery shop in Delhi. The first thing they want to do is they want to let people know that, okay, there's a bakery shop opening in your area. Right. So awareness would be the first objective. So there are two things. One is brand awareness and other one is reach. So reach is how many unique people you have reached, and brand awareness is sometimes you must have seen the students like you must have seen questions like, do you recall seeing the ad? So that is brand awareness. They recall how much awareness they have created. Okay. Next is consideration. So what is consideration is, now you have created a brand. Okay. Now people know, okay, there is a bakery in my area or there is a shop in my area. Now what next you want to do, right? So there are a few options. So you can direct the traffic on your website. So if you have a website for your bakery, that you can get that traffic to visit your website, or you can get engagement on your post, or you can have app install. So if you have an app, like, you know, Myntra has an app or Byju's has an app, right? So if you have an app, you can choose this option, app install, video views. Lead generation is when you are a service, right? When you are a service, you would like people to generate leads. So if you are selling homes, or if you are a doctor, right? Not that kind of doctor, but suppose if you are a hair transplant clinic, right? You want to generate lead. You want people to enter their name, email, or mobile number, and so that you can connect to them and you can solve their queries. And messages is when you want people to come to your chat box, or if you want people to come to your Facebook Messenger, right? Lot of the times you would see there are chat box there in pages, right? So if you will check VoxSkills Facebook page, you will see a chatbot there, right? So if you want people to come and interact with your chatbot, you can choose this option. And then the final is conversions, right? So conversions is when you want people to visit your website and then buy us something. So if you must have seen Amazon ads, right? You type anything you want, you type best laptops or best mobiles, you will see Amazon or Flipkart ads there, right? So they want you to visit their website and then buy something, right? So that is your conversion goal. Or catalog sales is, some companies have started using catalog sales. So if you will visit their page, you will see a list of catalog, all the products they provide, right? Or store visit is, suppose if I have a bakery, right? I want people to visit my store, right? So that is why I will use store visits. Let me check. Guys, if you have any doubt, just type in the chat. Okay. Also, do fill the feedback form that is shared. That is very important. So choose optimization. So how will you optimize your ad? So once you have created your ad, how will you optimize it? Right? There are a few ad types. So if you want your ad to be shown only on newsfeed, newsfeed is when you are scrolling your Facebook, right? Or if you want it to shown only in stories or in stream Facebook, such as that, this is all self-explanatory. Or you can optimize for impressions. Impressions is how many times your ads has been seen. So impression and daily unique reach. So what reach is, suppose your ad has been shown to three people, right? And they have seen your ad three times, right? So your impression will be 9. Your daily unique reach will be 3 people, right? Or your link click. So these are the things you can optimize your ads for, right? And how do you pay for your ads, right? If you're running your ads, there are two options. Basically, you can pay according to it. One is impression. So cost per 1,000 impression, CPM, M is milli. Milli is 1,000. So cost per milli, that is cost per 1,000 impressions, or cost per link click. So if you are a website, you are making an ad for traffic, you can choose cost per link click. So anybody who clicks your ad, you will be charged, right? So these are few options you can optimize for. So how does the ad look? Okay, as you can see, Aditya Birla Capital, you will see a sponsor tag here, right? You will see a link. You will see call to action. Call to action is what action you want users to take, right? So this is newsfeed in Facebook, right? This is site scrolls, sponsored, you can see, right? This is an Instagram, sponsored when it comes in your feeds. This is in stories. This is how your ads look, right? You will say sponsor tag, click through action button, learn more, buy more, right? So all those things. Metrics to measure on Facebook and Instagram, right? Now you have created an ad, you have run, how will you measure it? So it all depends on your objective, right? So suppose your objective was to sales, to generate sales. So you will measure your campaign success based on sales, right? So if you are spending 1,000 rupees, how much amount of sales you are generating, right? So if you have one t-shirt, okay, every t-shirt sells for 1,000 rupees, for example, right? Now you have run a campaign for 1,000 rupees and you have sold 3 t-shirts, right? So now you have generated 3,000 rupees of revenue, right? So your return on ad spend would be 3x, right? You are spending 1,000 rupees, you're getting 3,000 in return, right? You are spending 1 rupee, you are getting 3 rupees in return. So your ROS will be 3x. But what will be your ROI? Your ROI will be calculated after deducting all the manufacturing price or the shipment cost and everything, and your ROI will be calculated, right? So these are few metrics. Okay. Now we'll just start creating an ad. Guys, if you have any doubt, you can just type in a chat box there. So you can just visit this link, facebook.com/ads manager. Okay, and you will get an ad manager from where generally you run your ads. Okay, you can just boost post on Facebook, but it won't give you that ROI that ads manager will provide. Okay. So guys, let's start with a real estate campaign. So for example, if I'm a real estate company, okay, I have few homes. I have one home in Mumbai and one 2 BHK, 1 BHK in Delhi. Okay, and I want to generate leads for it. Okay, I want to generate leads for a real estate. I want to generate leads to sell my house. Okay, how will I do that? Just go to this button, click create. Okay, now you have campaign objectives. You can use brand awareness reach first to know people, but we'll just start with lead generation because this is where most of your money will be used. So if you have so out of your 100%, 20% will be used on brand awareness reach. I would say around 60% would be used for consideration, that is lead generation, traffic, or some other thing. Remaining 20% will be used for remarketing, right? Now it depends. You can change this according to your needs or business objectives. So, for example, if you are generating a lot of leads offline or from traditional methods, your retargeting will be higher. But generally, your consideration or lead generation budget is always higher than your awareness campaign, right? So we'll start with lead generation campaign. As you can see, guys, traffic is when you want someone to visit your website, engagement, app installs, video views, lead generation, and then messages. Okay, so Venkatesh asked, what is the base price of campaign? So see, Facebook has set a base price of around some 672 rupees per day, but there is no such base price. I think you should start with at least minimum 1,000 rupees, or you should be generating at least 50 leads in a week. Okay, or you can start with 1,000 rupees and see what results you are getting. Okay, minimum I would say would be 1,000 rupees, but again it depends on your price point. Like if you are selling something that is 2,000 to 3,000 rupees, you can spend 1,000 rupees. But if you are selling something that is a lot higher and have a huge competition, it will depend. Okay, we'll explain how you can select your base price. Which platform to be used for making ad blocks? I didn't get your question. Maybe we'll come to this. Affiliate marketing group. See, affiliate marketing is something which is very generic. Okay, like a lot of people are doing affiliate marketing. So how you can calculate is I'll explain to you in some time. Okay, we'll reach in ad sets level, then I'll explain how you can select your minimum budget. But I would say if you can be a little more clear, like what is the product, then it would be better, right? But I think affiliate marketing will have a lot of competition because a lot of people are doing affiliate marketing right now. So we start with lead generation for real estate company. So guys, see, there are three steps when you are creating a Facebook campaign. Okay, number one is campaign. Number two is ad set. And number three is ad. Okay, so these are three levels of Facebook campaign. These three are the only thing that will make your Facebook ad, right? So naming of a campaign is very important. Okay, so if you have a campaign name, you should name your campaign that in a way that it's very self-explanatory, right? So for example, so I'm making a campaign for a real estate. Okay, now I will write real estate campaign. So special category ad. So what special category ads are, if you are making an ad for like a social issue, elections or politics, you will click this special category ads. Okay, campaign details, buying type, it only has auction. We have just selected lead generation, right? From here, you can select your campaign spending limit. I generally don't add this because I'm if you are someone who is a professional, right? You will be visiting Facebook campaigns every day, right? You will be optimizing it every day. What people do is they will just keep a budget, like for example, say 1 lakh rupees for a month. And they won't hit any campaign spending limit, and it might get spent in single day or it might get spent in a whole month, right? So you can use campaign spending limit. Okay, A/B testing is something like if you are creating two or more sets, right? Then you will use A/B testing. Okay, it's a little I would say advanced technique, but it is used a lot. Okay. Campaign budget optimization. Campaign budget optimization is if you want to optimize your budget from a campaign level or an ad set level. Okay, so for example, like I said earlier, we have two homes. Okay, one is in Delhi, one is in Mumbai, right? So what I'll do is I'll be making two ad sets, right? One to sell my home in Delhi and another to sell my home in Mumbai. So these are two different campaigns, right? One is in Mumbai, another is in Delhi. Now I have one single budget. Okay, let's say I have a budget of 10 lakh rupees per month, right? So what I will do, what I can do is I can set a 10 lakh rupees budget from here. So it will spend accordingly. So people, if they are more interested in buying a house in Mumbai, it will spend around 6 or 7 lakhs on an ad set in Mumbai, and it won't spend that much money on Delhi, right? Or if people are more interested in buying in Delhi, so it will spend more money in that campaign, right? For example, if my home in Delhi that I want to sell is a villa, right? And a lot of people are interested in it. And in Delhi, it's 1 BHK and people are not interested in it. So I can use campaign budget optimization, right? So it will optimize accordingly. We won't be using it right now, but let me show you. I can use daily budget or lifetime budget. So generally, if you are becoming a professional, right, you will be using daily budget because what happens is suppose you are selling tickets, right? Suppose you're selling tickets for a cricket match, okay? Or if you are selling tickets for Disney or something, or a movie ticket, what will happen is you have made a budget for spending 1,000 rupees per day and you put lifetime budget here, right? once you put lifetime budget here, it might spend, like we know a lot of people are interested in movies on weekends or in cricket matches on weekends, right? So it will, what it will do, it will spend all your money on weekends, and then it will spend very less money on weekdays. But you want people to come on weekdays and weekends both, right? So generally, you will be using daily budgets. So this is all in campaign level, guys. There's nothing much. We'll go to ad set level. For example, this is for Mumbai, right? So there are two options in lead generation, right? Once you have named your ad set, there are two options. One is instant form. Instant form is you can ask users to fill a form, right? They will enter their name, they will enter their email ID, their mobile number, and they will just send you the details, right? And you can call them later. So that is instant form, right? And another is calls, right? If you are on mobile, you will see a lot of options of getting calls. So if somebody press that button, a call will directly go and you will be generating a lead. So these two are options. So we will be selecting instant forms. Calls, I would say, is better when somebody, when you're selling something that is required urgently, right? Suppose home improvement, right? Somebody who has got some emergency, or car towing, right? Somebody gets their car, and somebody such as car towing a car van near me or something, they need that service immediately, right? So if you have a service that needs immediately, you can use this calls button, which will work very good. But if it's not that kind of service, you can use instant forms. Okay, so home is something people are not looking immediately, like they are not gonna just click a button, call, and they're gonna go and buy a home, right? They need a lot of information. So we will be using instant forms. Facebook page, this is where you connect your page, right? Whichever page you made, so you will be connecting your Facebook page here and your daily budget. Okay, so somebody said what should be your daily budget. So you see your daily budget, as you can see here, right? Audience definition. So this is how many people I can target in this money. This will be defined. This will define your budget, right? So for example, let me do 1,000 rupees. Now I have 22 to 64 leads that I can get daily. And these are this many people I can target, okay? Now, definitely we'll be trimming the audience. So let's say 1,000 rupees is our daily limit. We want it to start today, or we can and we want this ad to start from tomorrow, right? You can set an end date, but we are not setting an end date. We want this to keep running, right? Now, custom audience. Custom audience is, suppose you have a list of people who inquired from you, right? Inquired about your home, or they wanted to check your home. So you can add your custom audience here, right? You can add your email ID, and they will show your ad to those audience only. Or what you can do is you can create a lookalike audience from that custom audience. So suppose I'm selling my home, right? There are so many brokers that are selling my home also. So they send 10 people to me. So what I'll get, 10 email IDs. What I can tell Facebook is I want to target people who are exactly like these 10 people. Getting my point? So if these 10 people earn more than 50,000 per month, all are from a particular area, it will start showing my ad to those people only, right? So this is how audience is used. Now, location, right? So for example, my home is in Delhi. Now, if I select only Delhi, it will be very small, right? So it says potential reach is 15 lakh, around 1 crore 50 lakh people, okay, in Delhi only. Now age, right? Now we are selling a home, right? We know that people who are 18 years, 20 years are not gonna buy a home, right? Generally, so let's say we select, as you can see, potential reach is decreasing, right? Potential reach is decreasing a lot as soon as we start selecting, right? Not detailed targeting. This is where your main job as a Facebook marketer or as a digital marketing expert comes, right? In what you have to do in detailed marketing is you have to target people based on their interest, right? So for example, we want to target people who wants to buy a house, right? So suppose, so this house, right? Or we can go a little more into detail targeting. So 1 second. So it was Mumbai. Or let's just say Maharashtra. So there are many questions coming up. I'll just wrap this up quickly and then we'll go back to questions, okay? Detailed targeting, okay? Definitely, we want people who are interested in buying a house, right? So we'll just select this option. Now you can just go to see, as soon as we selected this, you can see the number of leads we can generate. So it is, we will generate between 2 to 11 leads, okay, based on people who wants to buy a house between 30 to 50, right? For example, you know that you need around 100 leads to get to sell one house, okay? That is how you will define your budget, okay? If you want to sell one house per day, or if you want to sell one house in 1 month, right? And you know, okay, you need around 1,000 leads or 10,000 leads. So you will define your budget in this way, right? So for, suppose it says 2 to 11 lead. Now, if I increase my budget, the lead count will increase and my reach will increase, right? So that is how you plan your budget. And basically, I would say the minimum is, suppose it says 2 to 11, right? So I would say minimum I will get two leads in one day, right? So I would plan in a way that I get at least 50 leads in a week, right? So if I'm getting, an on an average, if I take 5 leads in one week, I would be getting 35 leads, right? So it's 15 less than 50. So that is how you plan your budget. And 50 leads in a week is like a bare minimum. You should be getting at least more than that, but 50 is like a very minimum, right? Now you can just hit suggestions and it will tell you all the options, like new house, people who are interested in new house, or people who are house hunting, right? Or people who are interested in real estate investment, right? People who are first time buyer. So these are all the interest, or you can use demographics here, right? So suppose who are financially better, if you have a big house or something, you can use top 10% or top 10 to 25% if you enter zip codes, right? That is how it will work. So this detailed targeting is very important, guys. Yeah, so somebody asked, do we surely get that amount of leads? No, there's no surety that you will get these many leads. And lead per cost will be like, if you spend 1,000 rupees and you get 10 leads, you know that lead per cost is 100, right? So it's basically the amount you spend divided by number of leads you get, right? You will be getting cost per lead in that way. Okay, so suppose I select all these interests. As soon as I start adding interest, my leads will increase. Okay, but you need a proper audience, right? If you are, suppose you're selling a home and you are targeting people like boomers or people millennials or people who are not financially that strong, then it, your money will go waste. Okay. You can add languages. So if you want to only, suppose you want to show, suppose I have a house in Mumbai and I want to show my ad to people only in who speaks only Marathi, right? I can add Marathi language here. Or suppose I am selling a home in South or in some other language, right? I can use that. Or suppose I'm selling something in Italy or Spain, and I want to target the Spanish audience, then I can add that language, that target only people who like target people who speak that language also, right? So placements is where you want to place, right? Generally, if a Facebook says recommended, you use that option. Okay, and if you are just starting out, right? If I'm starting out, I don't know that my ad will work better on newsfeed or will it work better on stories, right? Sometimes I see generally ads work better on newsfeed, but you don't know for sure, right? So to optimize it, start with automatic placements. So for example, guys, see, if I select manual placement, okay, it has a reach of these many people, right? Around 12 lakh or around 12 lakh people, okay? But suppose if I reduce the platform, so if you want to advertise on Facebook, Instagram, and audience network is a network of sites that generally Facebook has, right? So if I reduce this, so you can see the audience has reduced drastically, right? Now it has around 35,000 or people, but if I include Instagram also, your potential reach will increase a lot, right? So that is why automatic placements is necessary. You can use manual placement, remove this audience network, because audience network generally don't work if you are into lead generation and something But Facebook and Instagram should really be used, right? And now you can customize it further. Like if you want your ad to be shown only on news feed, Instagram feed, or Facebook Marketplace, right? So for example, I know if we are watching a video, right? And we see ads in between, right? I don't want my ads to be shown between a video. So I can just untick this, right? Or if someone is in a marketplace, right? If someone is in a market, Facebook marketplace, they are there to buy a thing, right? And if I'm showing them something unrelated to it, like if I'm showing them an adventurous post or a beauty blog, right? They won't be interested in it. So I can untick this, right? So there's a lot of options. So sometimes you are searching something and you will get ads in article, right? So you have a lot of options. Generally use automatic placements if you are just starting out. Okay, so this is all on ad set level. Now we will come to ad level. Okay. So first thing is name. Second, your Facebook page that you want to connect with it, your Instagram account, right? Now coming to ad, which ad you want to set up. We will come to this. We will discuss these questions. Just let me wrap this up. About job opportunities and everything. Venkatesh has asked difference between ad set and ad. So ad set is where you target your audience. You basically define, tell Facebook that where you want to show your ads, right? You define your audience. Okay, I want my ad to be shown to these people, right? And ad is where you tell Facebook what you want to show, right? You basically create headlines, images and everything, right? So this is generally done by a designer. Okay, designer will give you a image, a copywriter will give you all the text, right? Primary text, headlines. So all this will be given by a designer. So let me change the media. Okay, let's just use this image. Now primary text, okay. Primary text we can write. We want to encourage users to buy our house, right? So in primary text, we'll write some. You have options to add more primary text. Generally, it is recommended that you add 2 to 3 primary text, right? So suppose if you have a bakery shop, right? You will add 2-3 primary text like this is the best bakery shop in the town, or we use sugar free. Products, right? You will encourage them to check your product, right? So add few more options, add more primary text. We will write headline. See, you can edit all this side by side. Okay, you can see here it shows this primary text, all the variations. So suppose for headline we'll write by now. Okay. Or in description we'll write can see here guys, this is your primary text, your headline and your description. This will be a call to action button, sign up, subscribe, right? Book now. We want people to generate a lead, right? So we'll use sign up. Now you can create a form here. You need to create a form for people to fill, right? So let's just start adding a form. Okay. Suppose form name is, form needs to be very simple. Okay. You don't need to do a lot of things. More volume is when you want more people to fill a form, and higher intent is when you want a specific audience. Okay. It will just add one more step and let people to check all the information they have filled. Generally, more volume is better. Okay. Let's add an intro. Headline would be so any description that fits best for your business. Second is questions. Now, like people are coming, they are entering their details. So you would like their email, full name. I would say I would like their phone number also. If you want to know their other details like street address, city, state, you can add those details. Right. So work information, you can get job title, work phone number, work email, company name. There are a lot of options that you can enter, right? Privacy policy that you need to comply with. You need to add a link, text, a lot of details, right? And then completion, you can set a headline like after completing the form, thanks, you're all set. Or you can visit our website if you have a website, right? You can add a link to your website, right? So all these things are there in a form. Okay. And coming to the last part of it is tracking. Okay. Tracking is if you want to track, okay, how people are selling, or how people are coming to your website, or details of it. Like it will be done by a developer most of the time if you're working in an agency. But if you're not, it's very easy. Just click on build a URL parameter, add a campaign source, a campaign medium, name, and content. But generally, it is done by a developer. Now, coming to the last part of it, see, A/B test and campaign budget optimization, right? Now, I told you that I have one house in Mumbai and other one is in Delhi. So I won't just target both the audience in one ad set, right? I would create another ad set for Delhi audience. Original campaign, और एग्जिस्टिंग कैंपेन रियल एस्टेट एंड आई विल डुप्लीकेट दिस. I can add a daily budget. So, for example, if I want in Mumbai, I want to spend around 1,000 rupees, but in Delhi, I want to spend 2,000 rupees, right? So, I can do that. Okay, I can add 2,000 rupees, or instead of Maharashtra, I will be targeting Delhi. So guys, that is how you generally create a campaign. It's very easy. It's fairly easy. The main part is optimization. You can start running ads, but then you have to optimize it, right? So suppose we made two ad sets, Delhi and Mumbai different. Now we can make a few more ad sets, right? I would say in Mumbai also, I would add for one location a different ad set for another location. And for some interest, I will add another ad set, right? Even in ads, we will create few more ads. We will add more images and check which is working and which is not working. So that is very important, right? On campaign level, if I select, now I selected 2,000 rupees for Delhi and 1,000 for Mumbai, right? Instead, I can just add 3,000 rupees on campaign level. So these are very basic and things, but the main thing is optimization. So guys, now you can write your questions if you have any. So Mitali has asked, how do I increase the followers on Instagram business page? What options are available? Is the promoted post option useful? I would say definitely, if your only objective is increasing the followers, then this option is very useful. Okay, you can use this to increase the followers. But if you want to promote a service, then you should use this campaign manager, right? Vedant is, I want people to reach my website. I have a restaurant management and consulting business. What options should I use? So Vedant, you should be using, if you want people to reach your website, you would be using this traffic option. Okay. You would be using this option so that people will reach your website. How to set limit? I think I just answered that. Okay. So Hyder has asked, what do you recommend, campaign budget optimization or ad set level optimization? I would say campaign budget optimization is better when you are just starting out, when you have a lot of ad sets and when you don't know which ad set will work and which ad set will work. You should be using campaign budget optimization, because then Facebook will be optimizing it for you and you will be getting the best ROI for your money. But that is when you are just starting out. When you know, okay, these ad sets are working, these are not working, then you can just turn off the ad sets that are not working and you can add money to the ad sets that are working. Okay. So please explain about the new iOS update of Facebook. So I think this is little off topic, but I'll tell you the new update of Facebook is basically, so the new update of iOS is basically, iOS don't want to share their data with Facebook anymore. So the whole fight is about the privacy policies right now. Ki iOS don't want, like, for example, your GPS or where you are, and they track your data in a lot of ways you cannot even imagine, right? So suppose today we are talking about a headset, and suddenly you start seeing people, you start seeing ads of headsets, right? So it's not just that they are listening to you, it's a fake. They don't listen to you, but they know. Okay, suppose if I visit my aunt, right? I visit my aunt, I will start getting ads of the toothpaste they use, right? So they know where you are going, whom you are meeting, whom you're getting in connection, what things they like, right? And they show you ads according to that. So the whole fight is about privacy policy. And I would say it's a good step iOS is taking. So, and Venkatesh says, do we surely get that amount of leads? It's not surety that you will get those amount of leads. You can get more leads, you can get less leads. There's no surety, it's just an estimate that you might get these many leads, right? So Amrita has asked, can you tell us about the job opportunities? So there are ample of job opportunities in digital marketing. Just visit indeed.com or naukri.com and you will see a lot of jobs regarding digital marketing and social media marketing. Even we have a pretty good placement team in VoxSkill. They are working very hard to get everyone placed, and we have a very good track record of placements in digital marketing, right? There are ample of jobs, Amrita. So what, my voice is lost. Am I audible, guys? If you can write in a chat. If I'm audible. Okay, amazing. Thanks a lot. So we'll just return to questions. So Haider has asked, can't we track using custom conversions? So you can track, Facebook is all about tracking. You can track everything using custom conversions. From where people are coming, from where they are going on a website. If you want to track custom conversions on your website, you can use Hotjar and you can use other conversion tools. You can even customize your conversions in Facebook ads. Like you use Pixel. It must have got very quite technical. That is why I did not explain Pixel here. But the Pixel is a small code that you insert in your website. And that way you can track that who is purchasing on your website and who is not purchasing. And you can optimize on the basis of that. Or you can use a lot of other conversion tracking tools also. So there are a lot of options in the market. So either how do you reduce the cost per lead? Cost per lead, you need to optimize it. So guys, suppose I had this campaign earlier, okay? What I'll do is I'll break it down, okay? You can see cost per lead is coming. I had around 268 results, okay? Cost per result is around 31 rupees. So I'm getting one lead in 31 rupees. What I'll do, I'll break it. Okay, I will break it by time. So I would know which time in a day it's working best. So I would optimize it according to time. I can optimize it. So, or I can use it by delivery, which gender or which age, right? So suppose if I use age, okay. So see, I now know in my results, I'm getting results from 18 to 24. So I will target more people from 18 to 24, right? Or you can add by action, destination, delivery, age, gender, locations, country. So there are a lot of options to optimize it. So that is how you reduce your cost per result. So Shehzad, does this ads campaign manager works for Instagram? Yes, it works for Instagram also, for Facebook, Instagram both. I'm pretty sure soon it will be working for WhatsApp also. Yeah, you don't need to activate ad every day. Venkatesh, do we need to add daily budget? So you don't need to activate ad every day, but you should visit every day and check out the results. Okay. So Jaina, can you repeat the job options? So there are ample of job opportunity, guys. Again, just check out on Indeed, check out on Naukri.com. There are ample of job options. You can start with internship. You can start with like as an executive. So there are a lot of options for jobs. You can work in social media. You can work as an SEO. You can work as a ads manager, right? Ability how to convert followers into paying customers. The best way is retargeting and remarketing. That is how you convert followers into your paying customer. You keep showing them your ads and you keep generating value for them, right? You keep generating value for them and surely they will be converted into customers. So cost per lead is explained. Venkatesh, I did not get your question like champing. So either that, how do we get quality leads from Facebook? Like does lead surely convert? Since there's no surety, either that a lead will definitely convert, right? Obviously there's no surety. But what you have is you start getting a ratio, right? Suppose I'm spending 1,000 rupees and I start getting for 1,000 rupees I get 10 leads. Okay, so now my cost per lead is 100 rupees. Okay, so I'm generating one lead in 100 rupees. I'm spending 1,000 rupees, I get 10 lead. I spent 10,000 rupees, I get 100 leads, right? And now I know for every 100 leads I sell one of my service, right? So suppose if you're selling a t-shirt or if you're selling a course, right? You're selling a course, it was 10,000 rupees, right? So for every 100 leads you get, you say it worth rupees, suppose 15,000 rupees. So right, so for every 10,000 rupees you will get 100 rupee 100 leads. In every 100 leads you will sell one course, and that one course is price around 15,000 rupees. So that is how you're getting a revenue of extra 5,000 rupees. That again, a lot of money will be detected, like the teachers and other things. But that is how you generally get an idea ki how much you should be spending, right? So, guys, any other? Okay, campaign. So, Venkatesh has asked, when we get done with the campaign, how do we stop it and how the payments are done for the ad campaign, right? So see, campaign payments are automatic, right? Go to billing. Okay, and you can add an option, you can add funds here, right? You can use automatic UPI payments, Google Pay and other things to add funds. And if you want to close an ad, if you have already running an ad, okay, you can see this option, turn off campaign, just turn it off, right? So hi, there is 100 leads and only one sale from it, isn't that too low? So see, this is just an example. And yeah, like for example, if you are selling something very competitive, right? And when you're new in a market, for example, if you are selling a business analytics course, right? And you are very new in a market, it's very difficult to sell something, right? When you're new and when you don't have that much brand recognition, it gets very difficult, right? So yeah, you can sell more. you can sell two or three of them, but it all depends, right? When you start doing it, you will be getting a ratio. So it's just an example, guys. So, yeah, right. Okay, welcome. So guys, do you have any other example, any other question you want to ask? Okay, amazing. So guys, we'll be sharing your feedback form. So please fill that feedback form. It will be really helpful for us, right? I would just request Dr. Aarti to share a feedback form with you guys.
Sure, Ekansh, I'll be doing that.
Right. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, guys. It was amazing session. If you have any doubt, do reach out to us. You can text us, you can message us, you must have got numbers, you must have got messages from us. We will be happy to answer all your doubts, okay? Thanks a lot, guys.
Hello. Yeah. See, everyone, please, I have shared a feedback link with you. Please fill up that link. This will be very helpful for us to get your feedback, right? And also, I would request all of you to please fill it up, because we would be, you will be getting your copy of certificate through this feedback form. So please do that. Have you got the link? Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you for being here. Thank you for giving us thank you for giving us your time. I hope you have enjoyed the session. I am very much sure you might have learned something. And if you want to connect with us, please do that. Connect with us. We'll let you know when we are coming up with our next webinar and what would be the topics that we would be taking it up. And also, please suggest us what all you want. We will definitely come up with that. Thank you so much and have a wonderful day ahead. Thank you, meditation, everyone. You have made the session very interactive, and this is something, every trainer actually aspires for.